Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is Zero from TechDragon.info. And today we are looking at the Škoda T40 here. Looking at Dno? I think that's how I pronounce it. 95, by the way, at the end. Just trying to read the name. Škoda T40, Tier 6. I've tested this thing on the test server when this thing came out. Long time ago. I can't remember. I think this was a pretty decent tank, like just a decent all-rounder kind of tank. Nothing spectacular, but not terrible either. Like, mobility is good, the gun is good, aim time, reload, you know, just everything is very medium, but that's not a bad thing. T28 side shot. Yes, we managed to finish him off. We do take a small return shot there, but that's all we take then. Not terrible. Gotta be careful because we were spotted a second ago. I don't want to go up here directly. And we do manage to spot some of the enemies. At least I think we spotted them. May have been the leopard? I'm not sure. Kind of doubt that the leopard would be able to see that, but he's holding his fire here. Doesn't want to get spotted. That hog is definitely out of render range for us. Well, out of view range to spot him. One shot in, two shots in. As you can see here, gun accuracy pretty good, rate of fire pretty good. There's a chromo up there. Oh, that was some weird camera action. Tog, can we finish him off? Ah! Bounce, really? Pull back and run to get spotted. Come on, can we finish him off now? Yes, there we go. Final killing shot on the Tog. Take a look at this gun, because I honestly do not remember what this thing got for a gun. 220 damage, 132 penetration. 132 isn't all that much, but it is only a tier 6, so. But as you saw, pretty decent accuracy, because that was a pretty long range shot. Chromo coming up here. Chromo getting shot and lit on fire. Puts out the fire, is 150 damage away from death. One shot from most things here will kill it. T43 gets finished off. Cromwell still alive. Cromwell getting murdered as well. Things are getting murdered pretty damn rapidly here. Setting up for another spotting session here. And we managed to spot something on the hill there. Multiple things actually. But so they should be far enough away, so he shouldn't get spotted when firing. So, got a nice shot in. We got him tracked there, I think. Yeah, got him tracked. Good. Put another one in. Finish him off. Yeah. As you can see here, this is not a bad tank at all. At least from what I've been testing. This is a 9.14 replay. I don't know if they made any changes to this tank in the meantime, but back when I was testing it, it's like, this is about the tipping point where this thing finally started to, feel a bit nicer. Feel a bit more functional. Around the tier 6. Oh, Churchill. Nope, can't see Churchill. They have a lot of things still in base. And OI, another OI, what? Oh, just found a counterpart. The tier 4, obviously. Oh, get shot on the side. Churchill putting a shot in. Facing frontal armor, doesn't really help. Oh, Churchill, rate of fire. That thing is nasty. In case you hear a ambulance, police, whatever the hell it is, come by. No, he didn't. You're just imagining it. Wasn't here. Okay? Okay. Where the hell did that bugger go? There he is. I'll deal with this Churchill first, though, if we can. Try to put a shot in, can't quite make it. Come on. Oh, we just hit the top of his turret. Don't really have a depression in order to put a shell in. Side of the turret. Ah, shot goes low into the ground. Sure, we can make a shot from extreme ranges and hit and pen. What the hell did he just do? Almost looked like he rammed his ally there. Put a nice shot in, but yeah, the damage is really nice for a tier 6. Put another shell into his face. As long as we can just make sure that he can't shoot us while we're reloading, then we're gonna outdamage him. Easy peasy. So the two OIs are currently pushing through the field. As just noticed here by the pinging of the map. I saw it before the map got pinged. Woohoo! Good thing to always ping those kind of things for your team. Like, in case somebody hasn't seen it, big gigantic tanks coming your way. Be careful. Man, just looking at my FPS performance on this map is a garbage. Not sure, was 9.14 one of those releases that they had terrible performance with? No, that was longer ago. Coming up to this next bush here. Seeing if we can spot something. We do have view range just extending into their base, but I doubt it's enough. No. Probably need to move up like one or two more bushes. SU 85. And SU 100. Oh, balls. And we are probably spotted as well. Oh, and a KV 85, because why not? Shit. Try to put a shot in, can't quite make it. Somebody else tried to put a shot in. Ah, didn't quite pin. Need to aim a little bit lower there, need to go into his armor. Ugh. I know I said lower, but didn't mean into the ground, dang it. Oh, issue 100. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, ow. We tracked him with that first shell. Took him a while to repair, tracked him with the second shell, good stuff there. Going for another tracking and damaging shot just to keep those tracks off. And we should be able to reload before he does. There's only three tanks remaining. OI is on the other side, cannot shoot us. The KV-85 is on the other side of this hill, won't get to us before we finish this guy. Good stuff there. I've got to be careful that KV-85 knows exactly where we are. Right there. Oh crap. Oh, we didn't get him tracked. Oh, we can actually stay underneath his gun here. Put another one in. Put one into his hole. Come on. Yeah, you're not gonna damage him through there. What the hell? His tracks are still moving. Oh, somebody is putting in shells. He is getting damaged, not very quickly, but if you just keep him there, we at least get spotting damage, so why not? That still works. I'm trying to look for shots that would actually damage him and track him, but it's hard from this angle. And he's probably getting frustrated quite a bit, because he can't do a damn thing. Yeah, back at the turret, I would go for that shot. I put one more into his tracks. One more into his tracks. Don't get greedy. Well, actually, we can finish him off with the next one. There we go. And GG for the last kill. Let's take a look at the stats, shall we? And here we are with the stats. Master Badge, Ace Tank. We got a Bruiser, Duelist, Fire for Effect, High Caliber, and a Top Gun. Got spawning damage on the Crumble, on the T-34, on the KV-85, obviously. How much did we get? 236. Not that much, actually. And 261 on the STVZ-39. That's such a wonderful name. It really rolls off the tongue. Did 3,229 damage in a tier 6 tank. That is pretty damn respectable. In a tier 6 medium at that. 1,500 base experience. Matilda did really well as well, but yeah, don't know. Might have been a seal clubbing Matilda player with just premium rounds. That happens as well. But either way, pretty good game for the Matilda as well. Tier 4 and a tier 6 game, that's tough. 532, hit 27, pent 16. That's mostly due to the ones we put in the KV-85. I mean, we were going for tracking shots there, so most of those didn't pen, so that's why that number is so low. 1300 damage from range, that's pretty good, that's about half our damage. We took 5 hits to the face, all of them penetrated. Not that much of a shocker, this thing doesn't have that much armor, so. Spotted 3, damaged 7, killed 7, so pretty much everybody we damaged we also killed, that's always nice. Just shy of 1,000 spotting damage, 45k profit. Oh, of course this is the premium vehicle, oh, this is not the normal one. I got confused there. Yeah, I was thinking about that, like, wait a minute, wasn't this the... No, this was the normal one, right? No, this was the premium. Yeah. Yeah, no, the normal tier 6 is where that line starts to become somewhat decent as well. I think. Let's go to tier. Yeah. I'm so confused. Like, I don't have. Before, like when I was actively playing this game still, I could pretty much draw the entire tech tree for you and barely miss a tank in it. But right now, I'm a bit foggy. It's been a while. I haven't seen those tech trees in quite a while. I think they changed up a little bit here and there as well, so. Yeah, no, this is the premium. You guys are probably screaming already at the screen. Don't do that. Doesn't help. I can't hear it. Honestly, I can't. So, with a grand total of 1980 base experience, well, base, but premium plus base. Very, very nice for a non-double. Let's take a look at our next game. There we go. I can talk. I need more coffee. I actually need to run to the store for coffee, so. Yeah. Let's take a look at our next game, shall we? And here we are with our second and final replay for today. We have Iwaguth in the Panther 88. I actually enjoy this tank. It's one of those bizarre ones that really isn't all that great, but it seems to work quite decently. So, I don't know. I haven't played that many games in it. Like, I haven't played hundreds of games. That's a building. Good job. I haven't played that many games in it, but. Yeah, I like it. It's been good to me. I think a lot of people were giving this thing a lot of hate and it being crap and bad, and yes, that is still Waffenträger LV-100. I know they don't exist anymore, I think. Have they removed it yet? I think so, yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty sure they removed it. So we have an M41 90 GF. Grand Finals model. It's the black one, right? Yeah. Up in front of us. Yeah, the Black Bulldog, I think they call it, or the Black Dog, or something like that. Yeah. I like that tank as well. It's a lot of fun to play. It's a nice tank. So we got an IS-7. Oh, balls. Not what you wanted to see. Definitely not. Nope, nobody, nope, 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 nope. Oh, phew, he missed. This bulldog could, like, fudge off so we can get behind this damn rock here. Freaking IS-7 in front of us. Not good. So, what do we have for a firing line behind us? We have the Rheinmetall Borsigwaffenträger. Some sort of yak target? It's hard to see. Yeah, there's a yak target there as well. And, of course, the Waffenträger LV-100. Hopefully we can do some spawning here and get some of that lovely spawning damage. If we can actually see them. Yeah, possibly go up to this hill here. Just try to proxy spawn them. Probably, yeah, I was gonna say we probably got spotted there. There are two pieces of artillery, so. Oh god, it's an overpowered piece of shit French auto-loading artillery. I hate that damn thing so much. With a bit of bad luck, you'll get hit three times and you can't even bring your tracks back up because you get hit with the next shell before you can even fix your tracks. Because you fix your tracks after the first time they take them off, then they hit you again, then your tracks are gone again, and then you're gonna get shot by the third shell because. Reload of that thing, if you don't have a top tier crew, it's gonna be better than the reload on your, track fixing. Trying to go spot here. Well, it seems like the IS-7 did get hit a little bit by our arty there, but not really. Not really to anything decent that would be useful to us. Trying to poke the bush here. Oh crap, another thing you didn't want to see. Holy crap. Not fun. Not fun at all. That thing hurts. So, right now, I guess we're playing the light tank because the light tank is behind us. I mean, it's not like a light tank has to be up here. It is kind of a light tank's job, but, everybody plays their tank the way they want to. And I definitely, for one, will quite often play my command tracking shot Did it track him? I mean, he's sitting still, so I kind of would assume so. No, it didn't. Alan did. He was aiming for something. Don't know what, but just keep tracking him. That would be great. Doesn't seem like he has depression enough to shoot us. Somebody's spamming chat. He gets slammed the other side. His tracks are off on the other side as well. That's good for us. And he is gone. Nice. That's how you take out a tier 10. Very nice. Just track him and keep him tracked. And doing damage if you can with every shot. That means you're doing your damage. You're keeping him in place. And you're also soaking up all that lovely, lovely experience for spotting slash assistance. Sorry. Tank right in front. Oh, and we managed to bounce a shell. You're dead, son. First shot doesn't go in. Oh, we had a friend. That's not nice. Ow. We take a shell, but it actually didn't pen, so that's nice. He is nice, nice enough to turn us around there. Have our armor facing. He tracks us again. He's thinking about going for the Black Bulldog there. And, oh, we managed to pull back, but we do get hit by the Rheinmetall Borsig there. Waffenträger. So Grand Finals could finish him off. That would be fantastic. Dang it, a little bit late there. Would have been nicer to have him dead a couple of seconds sooner. The Borsig is looking for a shot. We are tracked. Please no, please no. Moving forward, moving out of range. I would swing a right here, get into the low ground. Give him less a shootout. Okay, we're good. We're good. Phew. That was scary. Somebody's not happy with Artie. Wait, was that double chat or did he just censor himself a second time around? That was a bit weird. Oh, he just fired. We don't really have the horsepower to go up this hill. And it seems like that we're only taking one type of shell here. Doesn't have any HE or any premium loaded. Put a second one in. Like, HE shells right about now would have been nice on this thing. Not sure what he's doing. Like, he's not even trying to turn his gun around. He's just running away in circles. Oh, he's reloaded. He's turning his gun around. Oh, crap, 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 crap. Oh, phew. Oh. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Waffenträger. That would have been our death because he was so reloaded. Whew, too close for comfort. Not good. Okay, last one remaining is the Batchat Artillery. Let's see if we can murder his face as well. It's gonna be difficult to get there in time though, there's a lot of other tanks there. At this point I would have said just screw it and go through the cap circle, there's no time to waste to go around. And that's GG, let's take a look at the stats. And here we are with the stats, Mastery Badge, Ace Tanker, we got a Spotter and a Fire for Effect. Spotter I don't really find that surprising. 600 damage on the IS-7, 600 damage on the object, and 666 on that one, nice. On the enemy Grand Final model, nice. So, we did 3,000 damage, got 1,184 base experience, quite a bit more than anybody on our team. We had tier 9s in here, not that many, but some tier 10s, of course. Not that many tier 8s, really. Just looking at the distribution here, a lot of tier 9s, a lot of tier 10s, this was a pretty bad matchup, really. But, yeah, this Panther with the 88cm L71 gun, it can handle itself. Like it can, you know, support itself, defend itself. Its mobility is not terrible, while not being great. Top speed is okay. It's just the horsepower per ton ratio isn't great, so acceleration is a bit lacking. But you know, the gun is pretty good. It's accurate. It fires. I would say could fire a little bit more rapidly, but overall, it's a pretty decent tank, and I enjoy it. So, fired 16, hit 15, pen 13, 3,000 damage done, took 5 hits to the face, 3 penetrated, 2 did not. That's another thing. I always like medium tanks with a bit of survivability, and that's one of them. Blocked 320 damage with our armor, spotted 2, damaged 3, killed 1, almost 2,000 spotting damage, that's pretty sweet. 58k profit with a non-premium account, and a grand total of 24, almost 2,500 experience. Very, very nice, and congratulations on that game. Thank you guys for watching. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, please subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.